The 100 Dresses Part 2. While the class was circling the room, the monitor from the principal's office brought Miss Mason a note. Miss Mason read it several times and studied it thoughtfully for a while. Then she clapped her hands. "Attention class, everyone back to their seat." When the shuffling of feet had stopped and the room was still and quiet, Miss Mason said, "I have a letter from Wanda's father that I want to read to you." Miss Mason stood there a moment, and the silence in the room grew tense and expectant. The teacher adjusted her glasses slowly and deliberately. Her manner indicated that what was coming. This letter from Wanda's father was a matter of great importance. Everybody listened closely as Miss Mason read the brief note. "Dear teacher, my Wanda will not come to your school anymore. Jake also. Now we move away to big city. No more holler polek. No more ask why funny name. Plenty of funny names in the big city. Yours truly, Jen Petronsky." A deep silence met the reading of this letter. Miss Mason took off her glasses, blew on them and wiped them on her soft white handkerchief. Then she put them on again and looked at the class. When she spoke, her voice was very low. "I'm sure that none of the boys and girls in room number 13 would purposely and deliberately hurt anyone's feelings because his or her name happened to be a long, unfamiliar one. I prefer to think that what was said in thoughtlessness. I know that all of you feel the way I do, that this is a very unfortunate thing to have happened. Unfortunate and sad, both. And I want you all to think about it." Now, its explanation. Miss Mason received a note from the principal's office. She read it several times. She studied it thoughtfully. Then she read the letter to the class. Wanda's father clearly made it clear that both his children, Wanda and Jake, would not come to their previous school anymore. They would not be insulted for having their funny names anymore in the big city as they faced it in their previous school. The letter had an immediate effect. A deep silence prevailed in the room. Miss Mason spoke in a low voice. She wished that none of the boys and girls in room 13 would purposely and deliberately hurt anybody for having a long and unfamiliar name. What was said in thoughtlessness. It was a very unfortunate and sad thing that Wanda had to face such a situation.